Hey everyone, Kyle Yates here, the Fantasy Pros Football Podcast. Thanks for joining us. Today, we are going to be looking at 10 wide receivers to avoid based on their current ranking in 2020. This week, we've asked our writers for wide receivers that they are most likely to pass on based on our fantasy football expert consensus rankings. Here's what they had to say. Amari Cooper, Dallas, wide receiver 9. Talent-wise, Cooper is as good as anyone. But the Houdini act he pulled last year down the stretch doesn't inspire confidence, especially with the Cowboys drafting CeeDee Lamb and Michael Gallup starting to emerge. There's a lot to like about the Dallas offense in 2020, but Amari Cooper is a better receiver in real life than he is in fantasy football. It seems absolutely possible that we saw him right at his ceiling last year. The Cowboys project to win more games this year, and they drafted wide receiver CeeDee Lamb in the first round. I worry Cooper won't see the volume to put up the numbers he did last year. Taking him as a wide receiver 9 seems optimistic at best. What's more, Cooper has never topped 83 catches or 1,200 yards in any season. To return wide receiver 9 value, he would have to blow past those numbers. I don't see it happening. Mike Williams, Los Angeles Chargers, wide receiver 39. Williams is extremely talented, but he had the highest average depth of target at 17.3 and yards per reception of 20.4 of any wide receiver, and he still finished as just the 39th ranked receiver in half PPR leagues. Now, the Chargers have replaced Phillip Rivers with Tyrod Taylor, who won't push the ball down the field nearly as much, and they'll likely rely on their defense and play conservatively. It's hard to see much upside in Williams from a fantasy perspective, so there is little reason to draft him as a high-end wide receiver 4. Cooper Kupp, Los Angeles Rams, wide receiver 17. Don't get me wrong, I like Kupp a lot, but his arrow is trending in the wrong direction while Robert Woods is trending up. As the Rams seem poised to implement more 12 personnel in 2020, those splits favored Woods significantly in 2019. More important in my mind is that the Rams added a wide receiver in Van Jefferson with decent draft capital, and they seem likely to expand Tyler Higbee's role in the passing game after his brief but impressive 2019 breakout. In Kupp's last five games of 2019, he saw 6, 4, 6, 4, and 10 targets with just one wide receiver 1 finish in weekly scoring. Kupp should still be a strong asset, but wide receiver 17 is a high price to pay for a wideout with usage questions looming. Odell Beckham Jr., Cleveland Browns, wide receiver 10. It may be true that this will be OBJ's bounce back season. Honestly, any kind of production would be better than last year when he finished as a wide receiver 29 despite playing 16 games. While I think he will have a better year in 2020 if he stays healthy, his draft price is too expensive to take the plunge. He is projected to finish as the wide receiver 10 in standard scoring, but this may be a little bit too generous for the former elite wide receiver. Mayfield has yet to warrant the draft cost in Cleveland. Even if he steps up and delivers in his third year, there are too many hungry mouths to feed on the offense. Beckham is going towards the end of the third round in PPR drafts. I would rather take Adam Thielen or Calvin Ridley as my wide receiver 2 with wide receiver 1 potential, or press my luck with Le'Veon Bell or David Johnson. Adam Thielen, Minnesota Vikings, wide receiver 12. It's downright comical that Adam Thielen is still garnering wide receiver 1 consideration at his current wide receiver 12 price tag. Thielen limped and hobbled his way through the 2019 season, missing 6 games due to an ongoing hamstring issue. While it's fair to attribute a lackluster 2019 to his injury woes, it still needs to be mentioned just how bad he was in Kevin Stefanski's first season running Gary Kubiak's offense. Entering his age 30 season, Thielen now faces, for the first time in his career, the weekly gauntlet of being the unquestioned marked man on the opposing defensive coordinator's scouting report. He will find himself going up against coverages that he simply never had to face while having the luxury of sharing the field with Diggs. The volume just simply won't be there for Thielen to provide a quality return on his lofty investment. Chris Godwin, Tampa Bay, wide receiver 6. Jameis Winston wasn't an above average quarterback last year, but he was a goldmine for fantasy purposes. In addition to being a QB1 himself, Winston's aggressive downfield passing helped turn Mike Evans and Chris Godwin into elite fantasy wide receiver 1s. The combination of attempting reckless deep passes and throwing so many pick sixes that constantly put Tampa Bay in comeback mode surely helped. The Bucs threw the ball 630 times in 2019, which is unlikely to repeat itself. We might not know what to make of Tom Brady's skill set these days, but we do know that he is going to be more cautious than Winston. It's fair to expect the Bucks to slow things down, not turn the ball over, and rely a little more on an up-and-coming defense that was underrated last season. This will make it hard for Godwin to command 121 targets for a second straight year. He's not a bad draft pick, it's just that he should be ranked in a tier of receivers that typically last into the third round. Instead, he's the wide receiver 6 in our ECR, drafted on average at the beginning of round 2. DeVante Parker, Miami Dolphins, wide receiver 21. DeVante Parker is the wide receiver I'm least likely to draft at his current rank. He is 21st on the latest ECR after finally breaking out in 2019, hauling in 72 catches for 1,202 yards and 9 touchdowns across 16 games. Parker did most of his damage once Preston Williams was ruled out for the season. In 8 games with Williams, Parker pulled down 28 catches for 400 yards with 4 touchdowns on 52 targets. Without Williams, Parker grabbed 44 receptions for 802 yards and 5 touchdowns on 76 targets. While he built a rapport with veteran quarterback Ryan Fitzpatrick in the second half of 2019, the Dolphins are expected to eventually start rookie Tua Tagovailoa in 2020. With the expected QB change and Williams' return from injury, it's going to be tough for Parker to finish as a borderline top 20 wideout in 2020. Keenan Allen, Los Angeles Chargers, wide receiver 23. Allen has been nothing but a great fantasy player for the last 3 years. From 2017 to 2019, he averaged 101 receptions for 1,263 yards and 6 touchdowns per season. The problem is the quarterback position. Allen is going to play with a journeyman quarterback whose career high in passing yards was 3,035 back in 2015, and a rookie quarterback that has never taken a snap under center. I could see Allen regressing to 80 receptions for 1,000 yards and 5 touchdowns as the Chargers try to develop a new quarterback in 2020. Allen won't be a terrible player this year, but he is being valued at his ceiling, which means there is not much bargain potential and nothing but the risk that a bad quarterback situation makes him unplayable some weeks. There is a potential for a lot of games this year where he fails to crack double-digit fantasy totals for the week, which is not intriguing for a top 50 fantasy selection. Stephon Diggs, Buffalo Bills, wide receiver 27. His new quarterback Josh Allen only attempted 461 passes in 2019 compared to 109 rushing attempts. Because of their stout defense, the Bills have become a run-first offense as evidenced by their 465 carries last season. They ran the ball more than they threw it in a league where we're seeing the trend going the opposite direction. Now add Diggs to the mix. John Brown and Cole Beasley have already built a nice rapport, combining for 219 targets last season. Like in Minnesota, he joins a run-first offense with two already established wide receivers that he will compete with for targets. For those reasons, I'll pass on Diggs as the ECR's wide receiver 27, and instead go with guys who have more upside and less competition for targets. Juju Smith-Schuster, Pittsburgh Steelers, wide receiver 13. Juju Smith-Schuster, the wide receiver 13 according to the ECR, finished as the wide receiver 65 in PPR leagues last year. Much of the fault for his lackluster season is owed to the poor quarterback play the Steelers endured after Ben Roethlisberger's season-ending injury in Week 2. Questions arise, however, when sophomore wide receiver Diontae Johnson is 42nd in the ECR despite outproducing Smith-Schuster in 2019 while working with the same quarterback group. Although he missed 4 games due to injury, even Smith-Schuster's per-game pace would have placed him behind Johnson in total fantasy production. Smith-Schuster has proven plenty capable of being a wide receiver 1, having finished as the wide receiver 8 overall in 2018. Expect an increase in attempts with Roethlisberger's return, but this team is aware that its strength resides on the defensive side. A return to the high-flying ways of before seems unlikely. The unknown ability of Roethlisberger to bounce back from a major injury at 38 adds another layer of risk to Smith-Schuster's 2020 outlook. When accounting for the risk involved and examining the receivers ranked behind Smith-Schuster, it becomes clear that fantasy GMs should invest their early round resources elsewhere. Thank you for tuning into the Fantasy Pros YouTube channel. Don't forget to tell us what you think in the comment section below. And while you're there, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons so you can stay up to date on all of our future content.